To take a look at the minor chord, it's marginally easier and marginally harder, I guess, depending on which way you look at it. So definitely worth paying a little bit more attention to. So you want that first finger getting across and covering your G, your B, and your E string, while your third finger handles the root. Same applies if we can get that third finger over to cover the A string as well, all the more power to it. But don't worry if you can't. Now the cool thing about a minor chord is you can be a little bit more heavy-handed, I guess, in what you're doing, because pretty much every note you hit, if you're familiar with an A minor pentatonic shape, or just generally a minor pentatonic shape, pretty much everything works. It's just a case of exploring what works for you, and it's the same pattern, just moved up and down. So, to try and incorporate that into the chord progression, yeah, I've just finished putting together a DVD of a couple of ideas that I get asked a lot of questions about. Put it out on Facebook and Instagram recently, just seeing what it was that people wanted to see me try and break down. And there were a couple of common themes coming through. So I've been looking a lot at playing with your fingers over your plectrum and how you would kind of go about integrating the two. Solo structuring is a big one. People pick up on, you know, how to kind of maybe go about building solos in a kind of, you know, an interesting and dynamic way. Been taking a look at what notes you really want to be hitting in those solos then, and how you can kind of work around the chords that you're kind of playing over. One that I guess that's that I've, you know, really frequently is the whole kind of Hendrix thing, you know, getting your thumb over and kind of using that to kind of thumb the bass stuff and then fingering some more interesting kind of harmony over the top of that. And then, and again, another big one is trying to kind of make your guitar player sound more vocal. I guess if there's anything that kind of people have attached to me in the past couple of months, it's kind of, you know, that faux kind of slide playing, I guess, making it sound, yeah, as vocal as possible, I guess. So, yeah, it's been a great day. Yeah, I'm really hopeful this DVD will be of interest to a lot of people. I think it's, in some ways, it's more conceptual based, this, you know, a couple of explanations of certain techniques, but I think for the most part, it's breaking down the thought process behind a lot of things and, you know, kind of, as with the solo structuring, you know, really kind of thinking about where you're starting and where you want to finish and the stuff that comes in between. And as much as I can't tell you which notes to play, I can try and break down some of the rationale in, you know, why I play what I do, I guess, and why, you know, great players sound the way they do and how they think a little bit more. So yeah, you know, there's some technique stuff, but I think for the most part it's going to be just trying to get some thought processes explained. So I think if it's for any type of player, it's probably going to be for more kind of intermediate level. There's a couple of techniques which, you know, really kind of revolve around, you know, in the basics, but again, this hopefully something to be taken away for anyone. I mean, the whole kind of, as I said, the whole conceptual stuff, you don't really have to be of at any level to take away, you know, something from that. I guess it's an idea that it can penetrate on any level, whether you're a beginner or whether you consider yourself an expert. But yeah, this stuff to be had hopefully for any kind of, you know, player. So it'd be interesting to see how it's received. So